Well, Russ, we have not spoken for a very long time. And I have a little problem here, which I think a person like you could help to educate the public with. And that is the increase of diabetes, but more so, the one that I'm more interested in is the kidney disease or renal failure that the people, that the those doctors would say is renal failure or renal failure. And I think you have some things you can pass on to the people on Facebook. So let me hear you.
Well, as simple. Excuse that there, SVG. Hear me there again. Now, a people without the knowledge of their past story, origin and culture is a trait of roots, says Marcus Garvey. Now, our ancient ancestor Imhotep teaches us that our food must be our medicine. So then, it means if your food is not your medicine, then it's your killer. So there's where it is. Now, all these diseases that is going around come from one simple thing. Now, there is nothing named disease, there is nothing named virus. It's called mucus. And then when your body get overloaded mucus, this is what happens to you. It's like the toilet system inside your house. You know, when you use it and you flush it, a little bit stay inside the pipe there. You come, you use it again, a little bit stay inside the pipe. And if you never get rid of that now, the whole thing backs up and runs you out of your house. So this is exactly what does happen with the thing what they call kidney failure, heart, this, that, and that. What is happening that we are eating? We are not eating food. We are eating mucus. Now, food cannot be grown in a lab, and food cannot be manufactured. Food must be grown. So even though the seed comes from a lab, it still is not food. And 3/4, 7/8 of everything that we buy in the shop is not food. Because food must be pH balanced, meaning alkaline and oxygenated. And that must be a pH count of 7 and up. 6 is genetically modified. What does genetically modified foods do? They create starch. Now, let me give you an idea about starch. Starch is the main ingredient in plastic. So why you picture that in your mind? That starch now create, like, let's say, if they make a plastic cloak and they wrap you up in that and tie it to, and you know what's going to happen to you. So just picture that plastic is being passed across your organs in your body. So grabbing them of nutrients that they should get. This is the same clogging what I'm talking about now. So when it passes through it, it is never free. The area is never free. Starch is a thing like grease. That is another form of starch. The synthetic oil that you buy in the shop, that is too thin to take heat. So when it turns acid. So when you eat that now, them fried chicken and them it back up in you. And besides again, because the only oil to use is coconut oil. Now food again. The chicken that you buy in the chicken shop could never be food. Now here, how we know fowl does come? We know fowl does come out in the yard, they are cock fowl, jump up and fowl, hen fowl and in their egg and then. So, but today you see food, fowl eat food and lay egg. So you can't call that fowl anymore, that would be something else. And you know, okay, that's a little bit of humor. Because, boy, serious to me. Hey, Brian, suppose one morning you wake up with your wife inside you and your wife pregnant and then you know you're not pregnant, she, and she knows she's not been now with no man, but she's pregnant. How it do I want that? Suppose I food we eat the hormones, you know, chicken we eat, cause you to be pregnant. Because, you know what I mean? Them things just amuse me, you know. If your food could pregnant the fall, it possibly